Want to speak real French from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at FrenchPod101.com.
The first subject is art. 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 French students take art lessons in middle school. It is called art plastique because students are engaged in artistic practices or activities. You could say, j'ai du mal à comprendre l'art contemporain, which means it's hard for me to understand modern art. Histoire. History. Histoire. This means history. Did you know there is a difference between histoire with a capital letter and histoire? L'histoire is a study of past. Une histoire is a story. It can be true or invented. If you refer to the subject, you could say l'histoire de France est passionnante, which means the history of France is fascinating. Géographie. Geography. Géographie. Geography. For example, j'ai un nouveau prof de géographie. This means I have a new geography teacher. In France, students study history and geography with the same teacher. That's why it is called leçon d'histoire géographie. Biologie. Biology. Biologie. Biology. For example, you can say la biologie est l'étude des organismes vivants, which means biology is the study of living organisms. Actually, in France, we usually say SVT instead of biologie. It's an acronym for Sciences de la vie et de la terre, Life and Earth Sciences. The next subject is chimie, chemistry. Chimie, chemistry. For example, le laboratoire est un endroit pour apprendre la chimie. The laboratory is a place to learn about chemistry. Chemistry and physics are taught in the same class by the same teacher. It is called leçon de physique chimie. Leçon means lesson. The first band is Louise Attack. Louise Attack. It really means Louise attacks and refers to the French anarchist woman Louise Michel, who was active in the 19th century. Louise Attack est un groupe de pop-rock français formé en 1994. Louise Attack is a pop-rock band founded in 1994. Yeah, I remember my sister listening to them. I don't think I really like them, actually. Noir Désir. Noir Désir. One of their best sellers is Le Vent Nous Portera. You should definitely check it out if you haven't yet. Le Vent Nous Portera. Don't remember. Noir Désir est un groupe de rock de Bordeaux. Noir Désir is a rock band from Bordeaux. Daft Punk. Daft Punk. This group has played an important role in the electronic music history and is known all around the world. Daft Punk est un groupe de musique électronique. Daft Punk is an electronic music band. Yeah, I love Daft Punk. Another great band is Gojira. Gojira. When they formed their band in 1996, their name was Godzilla. They changed it to Gojira in 2001. Gojira est un groupe de métal extrême. Gojira is a heavy metal band. And if you like beats, you love IAM. Oh my gosh, IAM. IAM. IAM is a very famous French hip-hop band from Marseille, formed in 1989. One of their best sellers is Petit Frère. IAM est un groupe de rap. IAM is a rap band. I love IAM. Petit Frère, I don't remember the song, sorry. But you should listen to it. The first sport is tennis. 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 In France, tennis used to be a high-class sport, but is now becoming more and more popular among everyone. Mon colocataire est professeur de tennis. My roommate is a tennis instructor. Yeah, remember watching Juan Carlos Ferrero? Oh my gosh. handsome man. The next is natation, swimming. Natation, swimming. Swimming is very popular in France. Nowadays, one of the most famous French swimmers is Jérémy Stravius. Ma sœur fait de la natation deux fois par semaine. My sister goes to swimming twice a week. Yeah, that's really good if you want to lose weight and tone at the same time. Rugby. 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 Rugby is especially popular among men in the southwestern part of France, in cities such as Toulouse or Biarritz. Vous savez jouer au rugby? Do you know how to play rugby? I don't. But it seems like this is kind of the same as you guys. You have, how you call that? This, the thing.
American football?
American football, exactly.
They're pretty different.
Really? I mean, this is the same ball, but you guys don't have that in America.
You do have it in
America. Oh, you have that as well. Oh, okay. Next up is football, soccer. Football, soccer. Soccer is definitely the most popular sport in France. Je n'aime pas le football. I don't like soccer. Yeah, France were the world champion in 1998, from what I recall. And I cried, I remember. Yeah, stupid. And then there is cyclisme, cycling. Cyclisme, cycling. This is very famous also because of the Tour de France, which takes place once a year and is one of the most followed cycling races in the world. I've never watched it, this is so boring.
14 juillet, Bastille Day. 14 juillet, Bastille Day. Le défilé du 14 juillet se déroule à Paris. The Bastille Day Parade is held in Paris. We can also call it La Fête de la Bastille or La Fête Nationale. Festival de Cannes, Cannes Film Festival. Festival de Cannes, Cannes Film Festival. Beaucoup de célébrités internationales viennent au Festival de Cannes. Many international celebrities go to the Cannes Film Festival. I have never been, but that sounds amazing. Carnaval de Nice. Nice Carnival. Carnaval de Nice. Nice Carnival. Le Carnaval de Nice attire chaque année plus d'un million de visiteurs. The Nice Carnival attracts over a million people every year.
I have never been either, so please take me.
Fête de la musique. World Music Day. Fête de la musique. World Music Day. La fête de la musique célèbre l'été. The World Music Festival celebrates the beginning of the summer. So it's actually happening on June 21st. Tour de France. Tour de France. Tour de France. Tour de France. J'ai regardé le Tour de France à la télévision. I watched the Tour de France on TV. This is really known in France. People love it. Boire. To drink. Boire. To drink. Drinking together is also a way to party and have fun. But be careful. Elle a trop bu. She drank too much. Yeah, please don't drink too much. Just drink water. It's enough for you. Santé. Cheers. Santé. Cheers. French people say santé when touching glasses before a toast. Santé. Chin. Santé. Devenir ivre. To get drunk. Devenir ivre. To get drunk. This is very common as people usually drink a lot at parties. Il est devenu ivre au bout de deux verres seulement. He got drunk after only two drinks.
Please don't do that, that's not good.
Musique. Music. 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 Music is necessary to warm up the atmosphere at parties. It is also a good conversation starter. For example, you can say, quel est ton genre de musique préféré? What is your favorite kind of music? I love R&B. Ami, friend. Ami, friend. Parties are made to make friends. Je sors avec mes amis ce weekend. I'll go out with my friends this weekend. The first one is 16 chaises sèches. 16 chairs are drying. 16 chaises sèches. 16 chairs are drying. Tongue twisters are phrases that are difficult to say, so they are a really great way to practice your pronunciation. Yeah, I'm having a hard time with it. Try to repeat them as much as you can. 16 chaises sèches. 16 chaises sèches. 16 chaises sèches. I think I got it right. Les chaussettes de l'archiduchesse sont-elles sèches, archi sèches? This literally means, are the archduchesse's socks dry, extremely dry? Les chaussettes de l'archiduchesse sont-elles sèches, archi sèches? This literally means, are the archduchesse's socks dry, extremely dry? Les chaussettes de l'archiduchesse sont-elles sèches, archi sèches? This tongue twister is probably the most famous and everyone in France knows it. So try to learn it. That is so hard, right? Try to do it. Les chaussettes de l'archiduchesse sont-elles sèches, archi sèches? Archi sèches? Un chasseur sachant chasser doit savoir chasser sans son chien. It means a hunter who can hunt should be able to hunt without his dog. This next one is very difficult. Un chasseur sachant chasser doit savoir chasser sans son chien. This means a hunter who can hunt should be able to hunt without his dog. Un chasseur sachant chasser doit savoir chasser sans son chien. Really hard. Suis-je bien chez ce cher Serge? Am I at dear Serge's place? Suis-je bien chez ce cher Serge? Suis-je bien chez ce cher Serge? Am I at dear Serge's place? I actually didn't know this one. I try to say it quickly. It's almost impossible. Suis-je bien chez ce cher Serge? Hey, suis-je bien chez ce cher Serge? Si, I cannot even say it. Je veux et j'exige, j'excuse, j'excuse. The literal meaning is I want and demand exquisite apologies. Je veux et j'exige, d'excuse, excuse. This literal meaning is I want and demand exquisite apologies. Try repeating it. Je veux et j'exige d'excuses excuses. Je veux et j'exige d'excuses excuses. Je veux et j'exige d'excuses excuses. I did it, right?
Want to speed up your language learning? Take your very first lesson with us. You'll start speaking in minutes and master real conversations. Sign up for your free lifetime account. Just click the link in the description.